messengers as bringers of good tidings and warners, so that mankind will have no argument against Allah after the messengers. And ever is Allah exalted in might and wise.
You're missing the word.
Hey man!
Hey!
What happened, Uncle?
I'm not Uncle. I'm Yusuf Estes. And really, the behavior that I just saw right here made me think about something. Made me remember about the warnings that we get from the prophets. You know what prophets are? These are the ones that Allah has sent to the human beings to warn them. Shall I tell you about it?
Yes.
Long ago, Allah created the heavens, the earth, and everything in between. Allah also created angels. Now, you know angels, they're made out of light. And they never make any mistakes because they don't make any choices. Allah chooses everything for them. But then Allah created the jinn, and He gave them the ability to choose, make choices. And Allah made them from a smokeless fire. Then Allah made His last and His best of creations, which is human beings. He made human beings from the earth. And He also let human beings make choices too. And when they make the right choices, they get rewarded by Allah. But when they make the wrong choices, then they're in big trouble. So what happens is that Allah sends warners or prophets to the human beings from time to time to remind them on how to behave, what they should do, and what they shouldn't do. Way back, way, way, way back, even before the creation of Adam, when Allah created the jinn, there was one jinn amongst all of the jinn. He used to worship Allah day and night, in the morning and at night. And then Allah raised him up, higher and higher, until he was praying with angels. Praying beside what? The angels. He was pretty happy, you see. And then when Allah created the first human being, He said, I order all to bow down because of my creation of this human being. And all bowed down except one. And who do you think it was? It was that one jinn amongst all the angels who would not bow down. He said, I'm better than him. Me, I'm made from a smokeless fire. Him, he's made out of dirt. So I won't bow down. And Allah told him, you know, you're going to go to hell for this. He said, I don't care. Just let me take him and all of his children to hell with me. Now, who was that? His name is Iblis or Lucifer. And until now, he still is trying to take the children of the first human to hell with him. By the way, would you like to know who is the name of the first of all of the human beings?
Yes.
Yeah. If you speak English, his name is Adam. And if you speak Arabic, his name is Adam. If you speak French, or German, or Russian, or Italian, or Spanish, or Urdu, his name is Adam. It's the same in all the languages all over the world. Everybody knows the first man's name was what? Adam. But then, over the centuries, people kind of got away from the message. So Allah had to come back and tell him again. And again and again, until Allah sent the last and the final messenger to the human beings and jinn for all time. And do you know who that was? Can you guess? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah sent him as a mercy or rahmah to the alameen, to all of the worlds. Now what happened in the very beginning was that Adam alayhi salam, we usually say peace be upon him. When we say any prophet's name, we should say peace be upon them, right? So we'll say alayhi salam or peace be upon him. And when Adam, alayhi salam, was first created, Allah created him in the Jannah, in the best condition. He was in the best place in paradise. But he was alone. Even though he could have anything he wanted, he could have all the food he'd like, he could have anything to drink he would like, he could do as he liked, but he was alone. So Allah created someone for him, a mate. And he created his mate from a bone in his side. And he created woman. Would you like to know what her name was? Well, in English they call her Eve. But in Arabic her name is Hawa. Can you say Hawa? Hawaya. Hawa. Huh? Now, when Allah created Hawa, she was the first woman. And from Adam and from Hawa, from these two, Allah created all the people who came. And then their children had children, and their children had children, and children, and children, until now. Which means, by the way, all human beings came from one source. So all the humans everywhere are brothers and sisters to each other in humanity. But when they come to the right belief, then they become even better. They become brothers and sisters in faith as believers. Now, after Allah created Adam and created Eve, then what do you think happened? They were both in pretty good shape, by the way. They could have anything they wanted. Then Allah gave them a big test. He said, you can have anything from all that you see everywhere, in all the paradise, in all of the heaven, they could have anything. Except one thing Allah told them. What do you think he told them? Don't eat anything from that tree right there. And what do you think happened? Well, the devil, by the way, he's called Shaitan too. Iblis, Shaitan, you know, Satan. You heard about this? So Shaitan came to them and did what's called whiswash in their ears and told them, eat it, go ahead, it's okay, eat it, go to the tree and eat it. And they went over and they took the fruit and they ate it. And then they were in big trouble with the law. Big trouble with the law. Because they ate the fruit? No, that's not what the problem is. Because Allah told them to do something or not to do something, then that's what you have to do. You have to obey. So they blew it on that test. So Allah ordered Adam and his wife and the Iblis, the Shaitan, get down, all of you, from here. Get down. Get down. And he put them on the earth. And Allah speaks about this in the Quran. He tells us that he created the human being. لَخَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. That he created human being in the best shape. The best shape. ثُمَّ رَدَدْنَاهُ أَسْفَلَ سَافِلِينَ. And then the human beings, they reduce themselves to the lowest of the low of the low. Why? Because they make the wrong choices. The wrong behavior, the wrong choices. Allah also told us about this in the Quran when he said he never changes the condition of a people until they change themselves. And specifically, the understanding we know from Quran that when Adam alayhi salam and his wife ate this, they brought this on themselves. They made their own choice. They made this mistake. So Allah put them to a new condition. Their old condition was good. The new one was not so good. Why? Because they changed themselves. Likewise, if a human being would like to be better, they need to work on themselves to become better. Because when you change yourself, inshallah, God willing, Allah will change the condition. These are some of the things that we've learned from the Prophet. Sometimes people will ask me, well, how do you know this? How can you be sure? What makes you so sure they're a prophet? The most important thing of all is to know that they always brought one main message. And if you know this one main message, you will instantly recognize, is this man a prophet? Is this person a prophet or not? How? By the message they bring. Listen to the message.